Madam Moderator, it is a very great honor and privilege to speak in favor of the nomination of Teaching Elder Joseph Kim to Moderator-elect of the General Assembly of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. Pastor Joe is an invested church planter who seeks out the lost and the dechurched, and he begins with those who are overlooked and displaced, and in many cases, even forgotten. Joe is deeply committed to reaching those who are in the greatest spiritual, physical, and emotional need. He seizes every opportunity to show grace and hospitality and humility, a listening ear, a compassionate heart, and an encouraging word. Pastor Joe is one of those unique followers of Jesus who is passionate about creating Christian community where none exists, and then sowing the seeds of God's word, watering it with his prayers, and cultivating it in collaboration with his brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. As Pastor Joe has gone about laying the foundations of the Hope Philly Church plant, he is keenly aware of the needs and the feelings and the concerns of other people, and he always puts them above his own. At a recent Bible study led by Pastor Joe, a 7-year-old girl had scribbled the lyrics of a song she was writing. And after the Bible study was concluded, she walked up to Pastor Joe with lyrics in one hand and a pink children's guitar in the other hand. And she said, "Pastor Joe, will you put my words to music and sing my song to the group right now?" On the spot, without skipping a beat, Pastor Joe began tuning this small pink little child's guitar. He set her words to music he created on this spot, and he sang the little girl's song in front of the whole group. And the smile on the child's face said it all. He made her day. And he gave every one of us gathered an example of Christ-like leadership that places the highest significance even on the tiniest of disciples. Pastor Joe has a heart for people that continuously seeks out the good of others, and that will make him a wonderful addition to the long line of faithful moderators elect. With that, Madam Moderator, I'd like to second the motion to make Teaching Elder Joe Kim the Moderator-elect of the General Assembly. Thank you.
Thank you. It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, please say aye.
Would someone like to?
Aye.
Well, did you second?
We need to close the nominations for the floor.
Thank you. I'm so glad there are people who keep me in line. We need to close the nominations. Are there any from the floor?
I move we close the nominations from the floor.
Good. Second. Thank you. Now, it's been moved and seconded. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Now we just close nominations and we got to vote.
Okay. We close the nominations. Now we need to vote to elect Teaching Elder Joe Kim to be our moderator-elect for the 43rd, at the 42nd General Assembly. Joe is a phenomenal man, and I am really excited for this. So, would you please come and bring us a few comments, Joe?
Vote on. Gotta vote.
I know. I want people to see who they are voting for. This is Joe Kim. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. Welcome, Joe.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Moderator. Thank you, Jerry Iamurri, for your kind words. I'm really blown away. It's not the same without Jerry, isn't it, right? Like up here, it's just strange not being able to see him up here. This is an incredible honor, one that no one should ever take lightly. And for me, just the idea of being moderator-elect is quite humbling. And it fills me with A, what I think is a healthy sense of terror, but B, a healthy sense of pride in our denomination. And this is what I mean. By worldly standards, I'm a nobody, right? So, but in the EPC, there is this seldomly discussed kind of egalitarianism where the presbyter with the biggest church and the one with the small church, the seasoned pastor and the newly ordained, the pastor entering retirement and the church planter who, like me, is just starting out, we are a church where each of us has one voice and one vote. We all count. We all matter equally, right? There is something here that by worldly standards, every time I think about it, by worldly standards, seems a bit absurd, right? That a church planter like me can hold the same office as Case Thorpe, wonderful pastor, brilliant person, Brad Strait, equally brilliant, highly influential Christian mystic. I read his bio, it was great. Glenn Myers, one of the wisest and most gentle of souls. I'm a musician, but man, he's such a great singer. Oh my goodness. Rosemary Lukens, she's doing a fantastic job. You know, there are so few who have her blend of gravity and grace, right? And I simply, again, by worldly standards, do not have the same pedigree as any of these folks. But even so, we are the EPC. We're different from the world around us. When I was trying to choose which denomination to join, I heard this story that happened in the East a while before I was ordained. There was a church that wanted to call a woman as its pastor, and there seemed to have been some question as to whether or not she, as a woman, was qualified. And when the discussion had gotten most contentious, a ruling elder from a completely different church stood up. He was quite advanced in years and had a reputation for being quite conservative on his views on women in ministry. But he stood up, he took the mic, and he said something to the effect of, "I have been at my church for over 40 years, and during all my time there, our church has never had a woman as a pastor, and while I'm still here, it never will. But this is the EPC. And if their church wants to call a woman as its pastor, then I and my church will support them and defend their right to do so. This is the EPC. We do things differently." There was another story about a disciplinary case that went all the way to the Permanent Judicial Committee. And the elder who was being disciplined, I knew this person and I had come to care about them. And I was pretty sure that this elder was going to have the book thrown at them. But when the report from the committee came back, the recommendation was to assign two fellow teaching elders to walk alongside of this wounded pastor and nurse him back to health. And when I read that, I turned to a fellow presbyter and I said, "Whoa, is this what counts as discipline in the EPC?" And he turned right back to me with the most serious expression. He said, "Yeah, that's right. Because this is the EPC, and one more time, we do things quite differently here." And I could go on and on about how I've seen presbyters fight to show each other grace during our most contentious moments, or how so many elders wrestled hard with their own natures to reach across some proverbial aisle and build relationship with people we deeply disagree with on some non-essential issue. This is the denomination I fell in love with, a denomination that has proven itself to be characterized by a deep unity on the essentials, liberty on the non-essentials, and charity in all things. This really is the EPC. This has been a fantastic GA. And Ed Stetzer earlier this week very helpfully explicated why our world is on fire and how that fire is probably going to burn for a few more years. Dr. Sandy Wilson very helpfully explained that what we need then is an uncommon sanity. And then something, the best moderator that I personally have ever seen in my life is John Doerr in the Presbytery of the East. And John Doerr says we need a steadying hand, uncommon sanity, a steadying hand. Ideally, that's what you want from a moderator. The only problem is, I have neither of those things, right? If you want to be a church planter, especially in this climate, you kind of need to be a little bit off your rocker a little bit, right? But this is actually okay, right? Because the EPC has never been a top-down organization. We are bottom-up. And when I was candidate's care of our MINCOM, I would always try to explain to the candidates, while it's true that the General Assembly is the highest court in the denomination, but even though it's still understood that the local church is actually the most important one, this is not the EPC. This is the EPC, yes. Right? And if the world around us is on fire, then let's show them a peace that transcends understanding. And let's do that by letting our sanity be known to everyone. And the Lord, who is our firm foundation and stability amongst chaos, is at hand. Uncommon sanity and a steadying hand. Let's do this together. To God be the glory. Thank you so much.
Go.
I feel like the brother just dropped the mic. He just tried to walk off. But let us pray for him. Lord, there are three things that come to mind when I think of Joe, and it's courage, it's compassion, and wisdom. And Father, we come to you asking that you give him that. He's demonstrated a level of humility in his speech and saying that he doesn't have all of the qualifications in which one would believe that he would lead in such a capacity. But I ask that you remind him that you've given him courage, not in his own skills, ability, and intellect, but Lord, by how you have gifted him, by giving him your spirit. Therefore, Lord, you've given him wisdom. And God, I pray that he continues to humble himself by fearing you, understanding that at the beginning of fearing you, there is knowledge. So Lord, he doesn't have to know it all. Help him to trust the people that are around him. Help him to trust the leadership that is in his life. Thank you, God, for the cloud of witnesses that continue to come alongside of him, affirming him that you have called him for such a time as this. And God, we ask that you continue to give him wisdom. There are so many different things in order to think through, insights. There are so many different situations that he could allow his brain to take him. But Lord, I pray that he focuses on how to care about your church by asking you for wisdom. People may criticize him. People may think that he is not qualified. People may have their own opinions, but you're a God who moves in mysterious ways. And so through your wisdom, Lord, remind him that you've called him. And for all of us, help us to be an encouragement to him, reminding him that yes, you're leading us. Yes, you're called now. But most of all, we're supporting you. In the name of our Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray this. All God's people say,
Amen.
Amen. Amen.